Vanae.com show. As you can tell, this is a little bit different because I've got three awesome, hot people on the couch. They got to share a discussion. Earlier today, we were talking about sex, orgasms, the female perspective. So I'm going to let each person introduce themselves and I want to ask some questions.
Hi, I'm Victoria.
Hi, I'm Sky, life and dating coach.
I'm Rachel. Hello.
Okay, so earlier we had this really juicy talk about this guy. There's a lot of guys out there obsessing about how to get a girl an orgasm, and they beat themselves up when they don't. So I want to get your perspective. How important is it for you as a female for a guy to get you off?
Very important.
So what if you're having sex with a guy, and in that course of an hour or something, you don't get an orgasm?
I'm bored out of my mind.
So you probably wouldn't give him a chance for a second?
I would, but better come with a nice dinner or something.
Okay. Okay. So you're working hard for the orgasm. It doesn't happen. You've got to feed her really well. Okay. What about you?
Something
Rachel?
Good's gonna come inside of me.
I love it. I enjoy the whole entire experience. Absolutely. I find just as much pleasure from the beginning, middle, and all of it. It gives me as much stimulation because. If I want to be completely honest, and I guess that's what this conversation is about, is that even if I don't have an orgasm within that experience, I can get myself off fantasizing on that experience later, you know, if it's that hot. So that just actually puts on more pressure for you, though, because the orgasm happens like that and it's over, and then the girl's usually just done after that anyway. So I need a really good experience from beginning, middle, and end. So the whole thing's got to be amazing.
Right, so it's not just about the end goal of the orgasm, it's the build-up.
In fact, build-up can last and have much more pleasure.
And I think that's what's kind of missing in the guys, that they're so focused on how do I get this girl off, and they're not thinking about the build-up, the foreplay, making her feel comfortable, making her feel fucking sexy for her to be relaxed and get into the place of getting an orgasm.
Exactly.
What do you think, Skeletron?
Is it my fault that your vagina's retarded? I come in. I do my part, okay? You need to do yours. You need to relax. You need to calm down. Why all the fucking pressure on me? What if I don't orgasm? Do you care? No, right?
So
why
do I get what you want? Only guys can orgasm.
Huh? You're going to anyway.
Not all the time, though.
You know? Can, like, stand there, look at a hot chick, and then, like, for a couple seconds later, you can
orgasm. But I'm just saying, okay, listen, I've done my job, okay? I've given you my best 15, 20 minutes, okay? And you don't get there.
Wait, hold on.
15,
20 minutes?
Okay, I've given you my best. 4 hours for the ritual. Okay, and you don't get that? What more you want from me, huh? I'm only freaking human, man.
Okay, so if that's the case, if you're saying that you're doing your part, then what is it that females should be doing to meet you kind of halfway and make this shit work?
Because y'all girls, the wiring on y'all all fucked up, okay? Because you have, I mean, a girl has to be mentally and emotionally there in order to, you know, a lot of shit has to fall in line. You see what I'm saying?
Right.
Men were constructed for efficiency. We there, you see what I'm saying?
Okay.
We in and out, okay? Y'all got this whole process, and
of course we are, because we're emotional and psychological. We turned on by our mental state.
I'm just saying, listen here. I give my best, okay? I can do some stuff. I might bite on some stuff. I don't even really want to bite on, but I can do it just to try to get you there. If you don't get there, then you need to call someone else. Thanks for coming up.
Okay, let me ask you something, okay? You're having sex with a chick, and she's a dead fish. She doesn't react to you. She doesn't like look like she's enjoying herself. That'd be the equivalent of a guy not making us feel sexy. How would you like it if you're fucking a dead fish?
So it's like a lonely night. I ain't got no action. I can call her a dead fish again. Listen here. For a guy to get laid is a very complicated process. For you guys, y'all can just walk out on the street right now, talk to a dude, and y'all have him in bed within an hour.
Right.
I have to go on the street, introduce myself to that girl, sell my bullshit to perfection, and still, I might be lucky if I hit that this week. You know what I mean?
Okay, so going with what you're saying, because we have a lot of options, that's why the guys have to step it up and make sure that we feel sexy, you know, we feel comfortable, the sex is going to be great. Because if not, she's going to move on to the next person. Yes.
I really think that's a really good point. And when you make a woman feel sexy, because a lot of times, especially if you're dealing with an already sexy woman, the guys make the mistake consistently of thinking, oh, she already knows. I'm not going to brush her ego anymore and make her think she's any more sexy. Are you kidding? When you get, like, her naked or anything, it's a very vulnerable position. I don't care how confident you are. Mm-hmm. Stroke her ego, make her feel sexy, do everything, because she's gonna perform for you that much better. The more sexy you make her feel, no matter how much you think her confidence is skyrocketing, make her feel sexy, because she will then show you the time of your life.
Just, you are so sexy, God damn.
Yeah, you need that, you do.
But it has to be really genuine, like you have to mean it, it has to be passionate.
Just say what
like
you mean.
Sexy. You
just
can't
say
just
you
say
see.
You can't just pull shit out of your ass and say it because you think that's what you should say, because it's gonna come off ingenuine.
I'm sure you're looking at a naked woman and you're like, look at that curve on, you're probably going through your head, you're looking at all these sexy
you
things, so you're turning you on. Speak
belt,
on
girl.
It.
Look at that.
Speak up. You know?
Thick.
Right.
Guys got this down. I've been with guys who are shy about being verbal, sex talk, pillow talk.
Mm-hmm.
They just like in their own head because they don't know what's appropriate, what I should say, that sort of thing. And it's fucking boring. Like, I want to hear, because if I'm verbal, I want to hear the guy's enjoying it, he's totally into it. So what do you guys think?
Can
like
you call
that
your names? What if a dude was to say, oh my god, you feel good, you nasty whore?
No,
I don't like that.
Whore, like slut, oh you dirty slut, I like this.
You've
had
some
issues.
Daddy?
If you oh my god. Like, I've heard some fucking.
I don't mind the daddy one. That's okay. I don't have a daddy complex, but I'll still call you daddy if that's what you like.
Right, but it's. But I think like the whole calling the names thing, it's probably like a small percentage of women who like that.
Oh,
okay,
true.
You know, yeah. Here's the thing, is I think that people hold back with sex a lot, whether it be with verbs, with their words, whether it be their physical actions, because, and a lot of it has to do with that boosting the confidence conversation earlier, but I do think people hold back what's really going on, and when you're really free, sometimes some weird shit happens, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Weird positions, weird words, weird things happen, but it's very rare that you find some, well, maybe it's just me, but it's rare that you find that freedom
mm-hmm.
to be able to express what you want.
So,
it's a fine balance. How free do you let yourself go?
So I'm hearing from you, Rachel, that like that you kind of encourage that. You want the guys to break out. What if they feel
I don't want them to call me a dirty whore.
Right. Well, mine is a dirty whore. That sounds like the ex. Like, that's something you should not do when having sex.
Yeah.
So
it needs to be like written on the bottom of this video.
Do not do this.
Do not call me a dirty whore.
Depends on the girl. You gotta ask. Mind if I call you a dirty whore?